I'd just like to show you the system that we've evolved over many years for our worm farms, which is how we produce our vermicast, which is one of the important strategies that we use when we're trying to grow nutrient-dense food. So the vermicast is humus that is hot with really high levels of microbes in it, and also balanced minerals, so long as we're putting minerals and like calcium into the worm farm food. And this is a really simple system that we do make all ourselves, and it works really well. So this is the basic unit of our worm farm. The pattern is on the database for you to use if you want. We make them out of Macrocarpa. This wood's never been treated, and these are around 10 years old. Every now and again we have to, you know, bang the nails or screws in again. But essentially these just go on top of each other. The one on the bottom, the first one down, we put chicken mesh on the bottom so that the rats and mice can't get into it, because that becomes a problem sometimes if they can get up in the bottom. So the first one down has chicken mesh on it, so that's this one here. And then we just keep stacking them up as we need to. We just tip our kitchen scraps in here. It's mostly only vegetables and fruit. And we just continue to put these on top as they're needed. They fit into each other really nicely. And then we just put a lid on top to keep the rain out. And we just keep bucket of kitchen scraps goes in there just about every day. And when it gets as high as we want, we get another one with chicken mesh on the bottom to start the next one. Put it on the ground. And then we'll take the top layer out of here, which is usually the undigested food and the worms, which will be just sitting just under that on top of the vermicast. So pull all that all out, put it in the bottom of here to start the next worm farm. And then what we're left with in here will be this. So this often has things in it. Well, it always has pumpkin seeds in it, because the worms don't eat the pumpkin seeds. And it usually often has avocado stones in it, but anything that doesn't go through the screen or the sieve that we use, we just put in the biochar, the bone barrel. So depending on what we want to use this for, we'll determine the size of the screen we use. And so this is actually a very fine screen, and this would be the kind of screen I'd use if I was collecting vermicast to sprinkle on top of seeds that I'd just planted perhaps. So look how fine that is. It's just unbelievably, it's just beautiful. Look at that. So that's magic stuff. And if I wanted, if I was happy to have it coarser than that, which mostly I am in the seed trays, then I'll just use one of these, which is, if you look on the seedling workshop, it's got the pattern for this. It's just a cover for stopping the rats and mice and birds getting at seedlings. And now what's left in here is a piece of bone and some avocado stones and some pumpkin seeds and a few bits of eggshell. So that can all go into the biochar barrel. And in here I've got vermicast, which is perfect for using in my seedling trays. I wouldn't usually put 100% vermicast, maybe between 10 and 30% vermicast, depending on what else I was using. And you can also use it in the garden as fertilizer. It's amazing, amazing stuff. Use it in pot. If you're growing things in pots, you can use it to feed them. So it's just a really simple system. The other thing that we use this these forms for is in the spring, for example. I'm going to do this quite shortly. This is left from last autumn. Last autumn, when we wanted to put our carbon crops in, we still had mature beetroot and carrots in the garden. So in order to free the space up for get the carbon crops in before it got too cold, because here it gets very cold in the winter and nothing grows. So we harvest the carrots and beetroot, and we use one of these with chicken mesh on the bottom so the mice can't get in, or the rats. And this is our subsoil here, it's just pumice. And we just put layers of beetroot and pumice, and we harvest the vegetables out of here all winter, which frees the garden up for other things. And we do the same thing in spring. In spring we harvest our beetroot and carrots and sometimes swedes and turnips, and put them in pumice sand in a cool place in these forms to store them so we can get our summer crops in the garden. So that beetroot's been there since last probably last March, April, May, June, July. It's probably been there like 5 or 6 months, and it's just perfect like the day it went in. So that's another thing that we can use these frames for. We also use them for growing kumaras and potatoes in.